My fellow panelists and this august gathering, Vaheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Vaheguru Ji Ki Fateh. I am happy that I have been made part of this gathering. For 2 days you are debating on the sanitation issue in this Indian sanitation conclave. As rightly our fellow speakers who have already given their lectures, that yes, religion can do a lot of things, and yes, they can move mountains. Because we have seen that when you go to a religious gathering, there are very few who will be critical, who will be analytic. Simply, most of the people, they just have faith or vishwas, and sometimes we also say anvishwas. The leaders who are addressing these gatherings, if they really are connected with the God, they will always guide the gathering towards what God is saying. And when I'm talking of God, I'm talking of every religion. May it be Hindu, Muslim, Jains, Buddhist, Islam, Christians, because they all talk about one God, the brotherhood, the humanity, the compassion, working for the downtrodden. But we also have leaders that when they see the gathering, their agenda changes. Then somewhere or the other, the God is missing. They are self-proclaimed gods. And there where we go wrong. Well, in Sikhism, swachhta or cleanliness is part of life and culture. And yes, every religion preaches this. There is a line from Gurbani, Pavan Guru Pani Pita Mata Tat Mahat. Our Guru said, if I explain this line, ki pavan, hava, wind, inu guru kya gya hai, pani nu pita kya gya hai, tarti nu mata kya gya hai. I repeat again, pavan guru pani pita mata tat mahat. Now the importance of all these things, ki we cannot survive without these things. And it is, yes, rightly said, that what we inherited, we are supposed to give in the same condition, if not better, to the coming generations. We should not make their lives more miserable, more problematic, what we inherited. Being a Sikh, being president of Delhi Sikh Gurdwara Management Committee, we have 10 historical Gurdwaras in Delhi. Otherwise, the Singh Sabha Gurdwaras, if I count them, they must be around 800. We have more than 40 educational institutions run by this organization. We have hospitals, dispensaries. In 1999, the 300th year of birth of Khalsa, because in 1699, Guru Gobind Singh, at the place called Anandpur Sahib in Punjab, formed the Khalsa. We thought to do something different or which is good for the mankind. The first ever we started Khalsa Environment Project. And you know, right from Akal Takht Sahib, which is situated in Darbar Sahib Amritsar, to Delhi Gurdwaras, we started giving saplings as a prasad. Like you go to Gurdwara, you get a prasad. We used to give saplings. Why? Because whenever you receive it from the Gurdwara, you take it home, you will put it at the right place where it can have air, it can have sun, and you also take care of that because the religious feelings are attached to this sapling. So this project was started by us. In Delhi only we have two nurseries from where we started. In our schools, in our gurdwaras, we educate our children about swachhta, about hygiene, about environment. When I took over as the president of Delhi Sikh Gurdwara Management Committee, we have many Nagar Kirtans, Jaloos jise bolte hain. And some of these Nagar Kirtans are historical, they have been there for last 200 years. But I used to see that whenever the Nagar Kirtan passes, there are stalls. Somebody is distributing water, somebody is cooking ice creams, chowmins, burgers, jo aajkal sara chalne lag gaya. Religion has also started taking a change. But when the Nagar Kirtan passes, and in our tradition, Guru Granth Sahib is always there, and it is in the front, there are panch pyaras, in 5-6. And I was amazed when Guru passes, and after that on the road there was all kind of rubbish on the road. What will people say? Ki Sikha da Guru nikal ke gaya itho? I changed this concept. We organized youth for cleanliness. And whosoever was putting salt, we used to, you know, make a list a day or two before. We used to give them bags. We used to provide volunteers, we used to clean the road. And you won't believe that on date I have more than 600 boys and girls from different places, from different backgrounds. Whenever the Nagar Kirtan passes, it is absolutely clean. And best was that in Times of India there was a big news on this, that Sikhs have shown the way. The Chandni Chowk market, because Sikhs Gurdwara is a historical place in Delhi, the Chandni Chowk market association called me and complimented that yes, what you have started doing, because every day there is a Nagar Kirtan or a Jaloos of different religions, and I think we must do the way you are doing, number one. Secondly, we Indians, now I'm talking about everybody, we only care for what we pay. We don't care for what government or the organizations have made facilities for your convenience. You see your own bathrooms, toilets, they are clean. You go to public toilets, you will see the difference. And I think when Metro Rail started, they wisely do away with all the washrooms in metro stations. That is the reason you don't feel any stink when you go to metro stations. The thing is that it is our duty, if our government, if our organization, maybe religious or social or whatever, if they are providing something for the facility, for the masses, I think we must take care as if ultimately these are our money. This is our money which is going into it. It is the taxpayers' money which is going into it. And it is our duty that when we use the toilet and when the other person is going to use, it should be as clean as we got it for ourselves. This mentality has to be changed. In Bangla Sahib Gurdwara, you must have visited many of you, it is just almost a kilometer and a half away from here. It is a lifeline for all the protesters who come to this city. As a president, in 2013 I took over. I see a gentleman coming to my room. He was coming from Bihar. He says, I am from Nitish Kumar political party. 20,000 people are coming to Delhi for some education. We don't have any place for them to stay, because if you are coming from Bihar, then you don't have any place to stay for 30,000 people. We have massive halls at Ratabgarh Sahib, which is bank opposite Parliament, and Bangla Sahib Gurdwara. And we need that for two nights these people will stay. You should provide halls to them. We have ample amount of washrooms, bathrooms. Langar is always there. Even 100,000 people come over there. If you go to Bangla Sahib while I'm speaking, you will see the amount of people there for Langar from each religion, color, caste and creed. I remember 35 years back when Baba Amte came to Delhi for some meditation. I don't remember the issue now. And he sat with thousands of people at our Jawar Jyoti. On the second day, there was no water, there was no food, there was no sanitation. Somebody from his organization approached the Gurdwara management, whosoever were there in those days, and everything was provided to them. If right now you go to Jantar Mantar, the place where all the protesters from all over the country, from different political backgrounds, social backgrounds, the Kisan Morcha, even Jayalalitha or Karunanidhi, or Kisan Morcha, if you have been reading newspaper for last 1 week, a group of Tamil Nadu Kisan are sitting on dharna over there. Therefore, yesterday I get a call from somebody and he says that I want to come to Bangla Sahib and I want to interview you. I said, what is the reason? He says, I asked those people that you have come all the way from Tamil Nadu and how are you surviving on this Jantar Mantar? So they said that Bangla Sahib Gurdwara is the lifeline for us. Thousands of people were sitting over there. They sit on dharna in the afternoon. At night, they come to Gurdwara. They have langar. And you see the washrooms which Gurdwaras now we are maintaining. We have also kept those people who are responsible for cleaning, the housekeeping staff. And I'm saying that if 20,000 people come, we are prepared to cater them. We don't ask them from where you are coming, which party you belong to, whether you are sitting against us or you are for somebody, some other purpose you are sitting over there. And he said that the amount of praise they did, that for first 1 week we had nobody to support us. Now all the Tamilians in Delhi, they have collected together, they have come for our support. So I think the religious places can be instrumental in this movement. And yes, you have to show the way to the people who come to you. In last 4 years, I have just been elected again 2 months back. There were four major disasters. First was on the 16th of June 2013 when Badrinath, Gaumukh and these places, we all know about the disaster what happened over there. The way my community went over there, the Indian Army, the NDRF, the way they gave us particular jobs, that how can we make people comfortable, how can we make the survivors comfortable. It was a massive job. And I must proudly say that yes, we did it. Then it happened in Jammu Kashmir. We went over there and there is some local problem as we all know. Even now something must be going on. For first day we faced opposition from Goliath only. That you don't go to the stalls where these people are serving you foods, medicine, the tents, the clothing, the slippers, whatever we could have provided them, we were doing it. But on third day, ਉਹ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਪੰਜਾਬੀ ਚ ਕਹਿੰਦਾ ਭੁੱਖ ਤੇ ਭੁੱਖ ਹੁੰਦੀ ਹੈ, ਭਾਵੇਂ ਹਿੰਦੂ ਹੈ ਮੁਸਲਮਾਨ ਹੈ ਸਿੱਖ ਹੈ, ਸਭ ਨੂੰ ਲੱਗਦੀ ਹੈ ਤੇ ਉਹ ਮਜਬੂਰੀ ਹੋ ਜਾਂਦੀ ਹੈ. ਐਂਡ ਦੀ ਹੁਰੀਅਤ ਚੇਅਰਮੈਨ ਰੋਟ ਏ ਲੈਟਰ ਆਫ ਥੈਂਕਸ ਟੂ ਮਾਈ ਆਰਗਨਾਈਜੇਸ਼ਨ ਵੈਨ ਇਟ ਹੈਪਨਡ ਇਨ ਕਠਮੰਡੂ ਨੇਪਾਲ. ਦ ਵੇ ਆਰ ਵਾਲੰਟੀਅਰਸ ਵੈਂਟ ਓਵਰ ਦੇਅਰ ਐਂਡ ਕਿਕਿੰਗ ਆਊਟ ਦੀ ਸਰਵਾਈਵਰਸ ਔਰ ਦੀ ਡੈਡ ਬਾਡੀਜ਼, ਸਰਵਿੰਗ ਦੇ ਫੂਡ, ਸਰਵਿੰਗ ਦੇ ਵਿਦ ਮੈਡੀਸਨਸ ਔਰ ਦੀ ਰਿਕੁਆਇਰਮੈਂਟਸ. ਸੁਸ਼ੀਲ ਕੁਰਾਲਾ ਹੂ ਵਾਸ ਦੀ ਪ੍ਰਾਈਮ ਮਿਨਿਸਟਰ ਦੈਟ ਟਾਈਮ ਇਜ਼ ਨੋ ਮੋਰ ਨਾਓ. He calls me on my telephone, thanking me the way you people have helped my country. I'm grateful. And same thing happened in Chennai also. I think even now when I'm speaking, if we all know what is going on Syria border, the way ISIS is butchering the people, even now the Khalsa Aid Organization, there's an organization which is serving people over there, and they know that moment they will be arrested by these people, they will also be beheaded over there. But I think if we take this religious power, which all religion, may it be Hindu, Muslim, Jain, we all have, we just have to channelize it and motivate it. Because my first guru, Guru Nanak, he started a langar with 20 rupees, which is all over the world now. So I think it is the religious sentiment, this is the power of religion which we should use for humanity, not against humanity. And I appreciate the way you have organized this conclave. I think we will all take advantage from each other, and we must do it because God has given us this place. That is why we are sitting on the panel, and if we don't do it, I think we are going against the God. Thank you very much.